Hey guys, welcome to this video. Today we are going to study about static functions. So what is static function? A type of member functions that can be accessed without any object of class is called static function. Means we can access a static function without creating the object of a class. We can access it using the name of class. Static member functions can be used to access static data members. Okay guys, let's take an example. Let's create a class. Let's say class A. Private data members. Let's declare a private static. Int, let's say n. So we have declared a static variable, static data member n here. Public, we have to create static function, static keyword, then the return type of a function that is void, and let's say display function. So we have declared a static function here. Let's also define this function over here. Cout. Let's say n. We have to print similar on the console window. So n equal to sign, and then here we print the n here, end of line. Okay, let's define this int. The name of our class is A. And then scope resolution operator. In this way we can access our data member outside the class. And is equal to, let's say 10. So we have initialized our static data member here. How to access outside the class private data member? Return type, the type of data member, then the name of class, scope resolution operator, then the name of variable, equal sign, assignment operator, and then value. So this value will be assigned to this n data member. Now let's define our main function. So in our main function we will call this static function. We know that static function can be accessed without creating the object of that class. So how to access the static function? Simply write the name of a class, then scope resolution operator, and here our display function. So we have accessed this display function without creating the object of class A. How to access static function without creating object? Simply write the name of class, scope resolution operator, and then the name of our function. Okay guys, let's execute this program. So n is equal to 10. So in this way we can access our static member function without creating the object of a class. So static data member functions can be used to access static data members. We can use static member functions to access our static data members. Static data members of a class are not created for each object. The class creates only one data member for all objects. The static data members is defined when the program is executed. The program may require to access static data members before creating object. Static member functions can be used to access a static data members. So we know that static data members only one memory location is reserved. There is no memory location for each object of a class of a for a static data member. So static data members can be used to access static member function can be used to access static data members. Okay guys, this is for this video. If you have any query, you can ask in the comment section of this video. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Goodbye.